2008, Kent State University opened up its first Air Traffic Control Collegiate Training Initiative class. It's one of our five areas of concentration, and as you look around you, it's kind of enhanced by our simulators here. And the idea behind the concentration is to graduate students who can enter right into the FAA Training Academy at Oklahoma City and go on to become air traffic control specialists. The simulators that you see here are the same ones that are used in the FAA Training Academy. And we wanted to give them hands-on, real-world training. We wanted to make them the best that we possibly could, and we wanted to give them a leg up.
I think the whole air traffic control system is like driving from your house to Cleveland. First you go on your roads outside your house, then onto the main roads in the city, then onto the highway, then back off again. It's basically the same thing. Towers, your small roads near your house. Approach is going to be the main roads inside your small city, your small town. And the highway is en route.
You can have a couple students on tower, a couple students on TRACON, and a couple students on en route, and they can run a mini scenario if it's been built for them and go from one to another. So they can do an entire problem and then go land at another tower. So they can do an entire process and see how the air traffic control system works from beginning to end, all right here in these three classrooms.
Basically what's going to happen is a controller or a student controller is going to sit at either the scope or the tower, and they're going to have a little headset on. And that headset's going to communicate directly to what we call a pseudopod or a ghost pilot. And this ghost pilot's going to be sitting behind another computer, either in a different room or behind the controller. And they're going to be actually controlling the airplanes that are going on in the simulation. This is actually on-the-job training. A lot of FAA facilities will use simulators in this type of regard to train their controllers prior to getting on the real scopes. And these simulators are the top of the line.
You can talk about air traffic control, you can tell them about the phraseology, you can play recordings of communications, you can show them things on a map and on a scope, but unless you actually watch the planes do what they need to do and you give the commands, you're not going to learn it, you're not going to understand it. Unless you actually see two aircraft run into each other on our simulator over here, you're not going to understand the repercussions of those actions, and we'd much rather them do that here and make those mistakes in a simulated environment than do it when they get to Oklahoma City.